All right, so we're here at Jerry's Fish Room, which he keeps inside of it. His business, which I think is just awesome. So he can come thought whenever he wants. And Jerry, how long have you been doing this for?
Oh, 18 years.
18 years? Now, why? Why Corydoars? What about them just drew you into them?
They're just a nice, cute little fish.
Oh my gosh. And how many species would you say you have?
I'd say over 120.
120 species of Corydoars. And they're breeding, because, I mean, there's tons in there. Oh my gosh. How many tanks do you have?
A little over 200.
A little over 200. Now, you're married, right? What's the wife think about all of it?
She thinks less is more.
Less is more. So does she ever come here and check this out or no?
Yeah, she's good. She's not a fish.
She's just happy it's not at the house, probably.
Right.
And then we saw this. What species did you think this was?
That's Blair Mystic's
Oh my gosh. And that's the bigger ones in here, correct? Wow. Now, you have multiple rooms, so what is this room considered? Is this more of a display room, or?
Just a grow-out room.
This is a grow-out room? So most of the babies find their way in here at some point? Now, in this room, what would you say is the rarest Corydoars that you have?
The rarest. Probably the parallelis. You don't see that very often.
Parallelis.
So there was an eye in the parallelis.
Okay. They're being shy back there.
Yeah.
Oh, here's one.
Yeah, the Evers eye.
That's the Evers eye. CW86.
With the high fins?
With the high fins, yeah.
CW86?
Uh-huh.
Wow. How many species have you bred, you know?
Most of them.
Most of all of them.
No, that's not good. Probably 65.
65? So you are just a Corydoars collector. Now, do you have any secrets? Like what's the main key to success when breeding Corydoars? Is it just consistency? Is there a specific way you do it? Specific water parameters?
A lot depends on the species. The main thing is just keep them comfortable. And
just keep them comfortable, consistent?
Give them the conditions they like.
Now, do you mess with the water parameters a lot, or? Is it just what yeah. they get?
Generally have better luck at a little lower pH, about 5 to 6.
Okay.
So we give them some water treated with
with peat or something?
Yeah.
Boston area. Oh, these guys are pretty. What are the ones with the line on the back?
CW062.
Actually, you know, that is really a good looking fish, and it, you know, it schools well.
Yeah, I like how they're actually free swimming.
Yeah.
Which I don't see that too often with Corydoars.
Yeah, I think those for the auction, I don't get jacked
for them. Really?
Yeah.
Somebody of them look similar. I think the guitars are more unique looking ones.
But you know, with the tail and the high black fin is just.
I mean, I just love how they're schooling right now.
Yeah, and in fact, they're free swimmers. That probably is going to end up in the Igneous and the Estatus. I'm talking about playing up in 9 different tails. Yeah. Oh, so you have to talk about that, like rock floors, the rock floors. So right now they're calling it 9 different plates. And I probably the pre-existing Scar Mishak would probably be one of those. Aspidors would probably be one of them, but they're and Hebrosis and Pygmaeus will not be the same. They're all dwarfs, but the free swimmers are apparently a separate category.
They're putting them into a different genus or something?
Yeah, they're talking about creating 9 different genera out of the Corydoars. I don't know how long it's going to take or whether that's going to happen, but there's a group of people promoting that or at least discussing that. Well, that's good. I'd be a feature. They crap drives me crazy.
Jerry, what are these banded stripe ones with the stripe on the eye and the stripe going
vertical on the back?
Axolotli?
Axolotli.
Wow. Those are gorgeous. Now, how old would you say these ones are?
I want to say 6 months.
They're pretty big. You said that you feed blackworms, you go through about 2.5 pounds.
I don't feed them to these guys.
No?
I feed fish for you.
What do you feed the grow outs?
If you get a flake food from Jemco, it's the cichlid frenzy. So I feed them a cichlid.
A cichlid or
yeah,
flake?
Food. I feed them. Frozen blood worms.
How many times a day?
Generally twice a day.
Twice a day? So you take your lunch break at work and you'd be like, I'll be back in about an hour. Come over here and drop them in some food.
No, usually I feed them in the morning and stop by and eat food.
Gotcha. I mean, you have probably thousands just in this room. Let's check out the next room. Yeah, you just can't beat it. It's extremely cheap.
For an LED light.
And they're bright as can be. So these ones are some of your main breeders. Oak leaves. Do you pick these locally or buy them?
No, this is a good old. Missouri's a good old.
Wow, you have these heavily planted. So do they just breed inside the Java moss, and then do you pull the eggs out of it, or do you just kind of let them hatch in there and then catch the babies out?
You know, some of them will lay eggs on the glass. Some will lay eggs in the sand or on the moss.
So it just depends.
It just depends.
But you prefer having tons of plants in there when they're breeding.
Well, yeah, they fry and feed off of it and hide.
How about water changes? Anything specific? You do them all manually, I see.
Yeah, we bring in, we generate our own water down the street.
Yep.
So, I just have.
So you just bring in huge.
Yeah. Oh, 330 gallon totes of RO water.
Wow. That's so cool.
Not everybody uses a fork truck to
bring
in water.
No.
So then we were using this to torpedo an RO water here and just let it.
Oh my gosh. How much peat would you say is in there? I mean, that looks full. And then you just grow the plants down here? Are there fish in here? What? Actually, I do see a fish.
You see an aquarium.
Yeah. I didn't know you kept other fish.
That's a lemmy.
That's a beautiful fish. It's got a huge nose on it.
Beautiful thing.
Now, are you breeding those down there?
Actually, I got a tank.
Oh, so you actually have them in a glass tank over there?
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of them in there, too. And there's a whole bunch of quarries that have been breeding in there.
That's so cool. I love the use of live plants. How about this one?
Yeah, just a different type of half beacon here. There's some bigger catfish, but they're not.
Oh, there's some big ones out there.
Yeah. So these are ones I've spawned in the past, and they're getting long on the tooth. Just a.
So this is kind of like retirement village?
Yeah, for those guys.
Wow. Your job of moss is thick. These guys are big.
That's got color.
Britsky?
These aren't bad.
I think it was on the
no, those are Amazonas. Nice.
I mean, there's like striping in the tail, and it's got markings on the face like sturbi. It's really interesting looking. I don't know if it's in the magazine or in the, I get the digital version they sent me. I think I've already moved it on my save thing on my computer.
Just look at them on a course.
Amazonas just had pictures of a group of them. And some do, but I don't think it's even been done on drive yet. But it's really awful. Because most of
the, I mean, just unbelievable.
You know,
species after species.
I haven't
seen a third of these. Jerry, where do you get these from?
You just find them like online and order them, or?
I work with two or three importers, and you know, some of them just come from places like West Pond or Aquacat sometimes.
So whenever there's something unique, they're like, "Hey, Jerry, we got these," and you're like, "All right, I'll take them." That's awesome. I mean, just amazing. I actually really do like this fine sand. It contrasts really well.
That's glacial sand, so it's spherical.
So it's what?
It's spherical.
And what does that mean?
It's a glacial sand, you know, sand that's been worked on by glaciers.
Oh.
It's almost completely spherical. There's no jagged edges.
So like it won't scratch up their belly or anything?
Exactly.
Where do you get that from?
U.S. sand.
U.S. sand?
I pilot ever saw.
Do you? That's the best way to get it. Man, how cool. More breeding tanks. Now, Jerry, out of everything that you have in here, what's the one thing that it's just like, that's your favorite fish?
The one that spawned last?
Yeah. Whenever they spawn, that's you get real excited about it. So which one did you recently spawn?
These guys are spawning right now. There's some eggs down there. There's some
eggs. Yeah, right there. Wow. Heavily planted. Just stay in here for hours and just videotape every tank, get them to come to the front. I mean, there's just too much to see.
Well, these guys here, there's only two or three people in the United States that run this.
Eric's one of them?
Eric's one of them.
CW16.
No, actually, I think he said he hasn't.
He hasn't spawned them?
Did you watch his video?
I didn't.
You did?
I didn't, no. What'd he say?
He said that he knew a guy that actually bred these, and the guy had extreme amount of agitation, you know, so the fish could barely stand it.
Wow.
And that was the only way the guy could get to spawn. And I've spawned these with just a little bubble filter.
I'm going to give him a hard time when I see him.
I told him that. I said, you know, that guy probably, they spawned for him despite the what he was doing.
Yeah, they probably felt like they were going to die, so we have to spawn.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Where'd you see your first Corydoras at?
Growing up at a pet shop. There's a pet shop just two or three blocks from our house. So.
Was it the one that went out of business, the... What was it called? Belts?
No, this one called Henze.
Henze?
Yeah, it wasn't anywhere near the size of Belts. It was a nice shot. Yeah, so we had probably Julii and
yeah,
a few like that. So.
And you and your brother both got into it? So I know you said he's been helping you out a little bit. So did he get into it about the same time, or was he into it first?
Well, you know, when we were kids, my dad wanted us an aquarium because we wanted a dog.
He didn't want to do a dog, so you got fish. Is your dad still around?
No, he doesn't.
Did he get to see this fish room, though? No. He probably would have laughed at himself knowing that getting you a fish tank turned into this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at this monster.
Holy smokes.
That's the Broca's macrocheirinus.
That's a big fish. That gets a lot of bloodworms?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Unbelievable collection. I've never seen these guys, and I think those are stunning. And I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. What do you think, Steve? Can you say it?
Which guy are we talking about?
These ones?
Actually, that's a mixture. There's a whole bunch of different fish in there.
Yeah. Okay. These ones with, like, the checkered pattern are awesome.
So there's some violinianus and
So Ian Fuller thought this was pretty cool.
I think so.
All I've heard was good things about it. These almost look like pygmy quarries.
No, those are very slow-growing juveniles with violinianus.
Are these different from the ones we saw in the back? Because, again, I'm loving how they're schooling right now.
Yeah, those are different. Those were CW62s.
Yeah, CW62s. Holy smokes. So Eric Bodrock has seen this?
He saw, you know, I had everything down in another building. Actually, there were two buildings. You know, I put everything, consolidated everything here. He was having a, this is a lot bigger than what we had.
Gotcha.
Yeah,
if he got to see this, his favorite fish ever is Corydoras. So I know that he would be in here for hours asking you questions and talking with you.
He's quite good at it.
He is a very, very good breeder. His fishery is one of my favorite that I've gone to. Just because he has four different fish rooms and everything's different.
Actually, these parallels I bought from him.
Dude, that's a gorgeous fish. It's amazing how many different patterns there are.
There are. Actually, these originated for him, too. I got this.
Gina do a really nice job.
According to Ian, only one person in the world has ever spawned those.
And it's not you?
It ain't me, unfortunately. I did what, I've tried what the lady said. It was a lady in Sweden, I believe. And I've been trying to do what she said she did.
She speaks Swedish to him.
That might be the thing.
Yep.
Now, what did she say to do? Anything crazy?
No, she just had heavy. She had peak water and, you know, our pH. I've tried that. It didn't
take to
it. It could be the time of year, too. You
know. Oh, yeah. The atmospheric pressure is always.
Yeah, some of these guys are sick.
Is this a quarry?
No.
Wow, you got a couple different species. So cool. So how much time do you normally spend in here? Is it a daily routine?
Yeah, I feed them every day. I start out feeding them the small guys, baby brine shrimp, and then so 2 hours a day feeding them, and then there's probably another 6 or 8 hours on the weekend. So
jeez,
it's a part-time job.
Oh, for sure. Couple more non-quarries.
I imagine pulling them from the same responsibility. I don't know what the rivalry is. They both read catfish books.
Well, these are those half beaks.
Don't believe each other.
Now, these are pretty hard to spawn, aren't they? Jerry?
Not so much.
So, when you feed, you probably feed these guys a ton of blackworm.
No, I feed them some, I just feed bloodworms, flies. Wingless fruit flies.
Wow. You got a couple rasboras in there too.
Yeah, those are some I spawned some years back. They're getting along on the tooth too.
Some big females back there. Oh, I know this one, Hebrosis. Love those.
Yeah, I had one 40-gallon tank.
Yeah, just much better. Oh, look at that moss growing out of the tank. That's pretty cool. There's an adult. Wow, you probably got 50, 100 babies in there.
Yeah, every so often we have to harvest.
Move them to the grow out room or something. Yeah, how often do you have to go through and harvest them?
I'm sorry?
How often do you have to go through and harvest them?
Every once a month.
Once a month?
Yeah.
That's pretty often.
Yeah.
Now, Jerry, if you could give one piece of advice for all the Corydoras lovers out there, what would you give them for breeding them or keeping them?
You know, I think the most important thing is to go through, you know, or look at your aquarium in the dark. You know, just get a flashlight. You know, just look on the surface there. J- just check out if you've got fry, because a lot of times you never know that they've spawned.
Really?
They're laying in the sand, or they're hiding their eggs somewhere.
So at night they tend to come to the top?
No, what the fry will generally be active very early in the morning when it's still dark.
Okay.
So, if you just take a flashlight, shine it down around the bottom there.
They'll scatter?
Sometimes they're so small you can barely see them.
Yeah.
And so, when they dart, you don't know you got them until they dart.
Yeah.
Some fry are fairly good size, so they're easy to spot, but some of them are extremely small. So.
Yeah.
And so then you can take some kind of action, remove the adults, or at least start feeding them, get them something
to feed on. So. Typically you let them grow out in the tank?
Yeah, well, one problem is room. I don't have any place to.
Yeah, you need another 200 tanks.
I do. So unless it's a fish I really am concerned about, I'll just leave the adults in the tank.
Yeah, so if it's one of the ones that you've never spawned before, then you do a little bit more due diligence.
Yeah, then I
intervene. Oh, cool.
But I think a lot of times these quarries are spawning for them, they just don't know it. And the fry don't survive because there's nothing to feed on, or something eats them.
So that's where the moss comes into play, too. You said that's a good hiding place, a good feeding spot for the fry.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, every single one of your tanks has a lot of plants, which I think helps a lot.
Yeah, I'll tell you, with these LED lights, the moss grows pretty fast.
Yeah, I mean... Yeah, like you said, for $15, $16, you can't beat it. And they last. Anything we missed that we really need to see? I mean, there's a lot to take in. I would have to take up about 4 hours of your time to really get into everything. Yeah, there's everything. Jerry, thank you so much for letting us check out your fish room. I really appreciate it.
Well, I'm glad you came.
Yeah.